What up, what up? WINBUSH here. And today I'm going to show you guys how we can make this medieval bazaar all inside of Unreal Engine 5.2, all procedurally created and using all assets from Cargo by Kitbash 3D. Now, just a quick overview. I'm inside of Unreal Engine 5.2 right now. And if I look through my scene here, you can see I have all these items here. These were all placed procedurally, and this is using PCG that's new inside of Unreal Engine 5.2. So if I keep scrolling up here, you can see I have a lot of tents, I have a lot of different items in here, and I didn't have to hand place anything that's in here. Now I'm going to show you guys how we could create this with a brand new scene, but first let me come down here to my content drawer, and then I'm going to look at my PCG graph right here, just to give you guys a kind of an idea of how I built this out. So you can see right now I have my input, I have my surface sampler, and then I have some transform points, and then I have four different items all right here, and they're all being filtered out using this density filter. So I'm going to show you exactly how we could build this off from scratch, but I just wanted to give you an overview of how all this was created. As you can see, it's super simple but really effective. Now the first thing you want to do, of course, you want to start off with a brand new scene, in which I used a broadcast and film one, but I have a blank slate right here. So I'm going to come up to the top here where it says edit. I'm going to come down here to plugins. Now with my plugin selected, I'm going to type in procedural like so, and then you'll see that these two are off by default. So you want to turn both of these on to say procedural content generation. Again, make sure both of these are on, and then in the lower right hand corner, you're going to see that it's going to say restart. So we want to restart it. And while that's restarting, I'm going to open up Cargo by Kitbash because we need to make sure this is installed in our new project. So with it currently opened up, hopefully you have it installed. I'm going to come down here on the left hand side where it says account. And then down here at the very bottom where it says add new software, and then right here, select the software, you would select Unreal, and then your version number, they have 5.1 and 5.2. And then right here, it's going to say, please close all instances of Unreal Engine. So I'm going to go back here to where I have my blank scene. I'm just going to come up here and close this out. Just go with the directions as they are displayed. And then right here, I'm going to click on next. And then it's going to say, create a new project file, which I already have. But if you already have a project, you're just going to put it in right here. In which once you have your Explorer open, you just want to look for your project file, which I just have called Cargo right here. It should have an Unreal Engine symbol. So you're going to select this and then you're going to click open, and now it's going to let you continue. So this is going to take a few moments to install the plugin. And once it's done, it's going to pop up with this window right here. It's going to tell you basically to open up your project. And so I'm going to do that right now. And with my project reopen, I'm going to come up here to where it says window. I'm going to scroll down. And under enable full screen, you're going to see this button. It's grayed out. It says Cargo. So I'm going to hit this to enable it. And now once I'm back inside of Cargo, you can see now we can proceed. So I'm just going to hit the next button, and it's going to say there's going to have a connection test. So what we're going to do is once this turns yellow, you're going to hit import, and it's going to make sure that it imports this castle just to make sure everything's connected. And once it is, it's going to say everything is complete. And then I'm going to open up Unreal just to make sure everything's important. It looks like it's importing the materials right now, so just give us a moment. And once it's done, you can see now we have a castle imported, and that means that Cargo is successfully installed here inside of your Unreal Engine project. So I'm just going to delete this out of my scene. And if I come down here to my content drawer, you can see now we have a folder called Cargo. If I come down here to actors, you can see it made a blueprint actor for that castle. So if you wanted to bring this back in, just click and drag it into your scene, and there you go. So it's as easy as that. So now comes the fun part. If you guys have some Kitbash stuff, and there's even some free stuff on there as well, inside the Cargo, you're going to be able to select and import everything you want. If you're familiar with mega scans, it works exactly the same way. So back inside of Cargo here, I'm actually going to click on models, and up here at the top where it says axis, we have several different options. Now we have some free models that we can pick from. As you can see, we have a lot of free stuff. So even if you don't have any Kitbash models, even though they have a bunch of free packs, so I would say go to the website and check that out. You should have access to a bunch of stuff to get you started. And then also, if you own some, if you click on owned, you'll see all the different models that you own from all the different packs. So what I'm going to do is actually come over here to where it says downloaded. Okay, I downloaded a couple for that scene there. And you can see these are all the different ones that I have downloaded already. But if you want to start fresh, let me actually do this, just to give you guys an idea of how it works. So let's say I wanted to add this tavern in here. I'm just going to left click on it. And then over here on the right hand side where it says tavern, you can select your texture size. I use JPEGs just because they're a little bit more smaller, but usually go to 4K JPEG like so. You can see the difference right there, 227 megabytes compared to 1.22 gigabytes. So I'm just going to select this right here. And then you would just click download. So I'm going to go back to ones I already have downloaded. I'm going to start adding them in. So let's say this market tent right here, come down here, 4K JPEG. And once I selected that, you can see it switched over to import because I already have this downloaded. So I'm going to click on import. And once it's done importing, you're going to see it automatically shows up in your outliner and it shows up in your viewport as well. So everything here is already all set up, which I think is really neat, because if I come down here to the content drawer, let me dock it in my panel, come down to cargo, actors, you can see it just made a blueprint for it. So it has all the different items inside that blueprint there. But let me actually delete this, because if I come down here to geometry, we have all the separate items as well. So let's say if we didn't want the tent and we just wanted some barrels, you can come in here. It has a static mesh right there and you can just bring that in as well. So it's going to bring in the complete blueprint and also just the different static meshes as well. So you have some variety there. So from here, I'm going to import a couple more just so I have some variety there. And then we're going to get over to PCG and I'm going to show you how we can connect this to make everything go on our terrain all procedurally. So from here, you can see inside my content browser, I added a few more items just to give us variety. Then I also went to mega scans. I got a cobblestone floor because the next thing we need to do is we need to make a landscape so we have something to build on. So in my top left hand corner here, I'm going to come up here to where it says selection mode. I'm going to come down here to landscape and I'm just going to make a simple landscape. So down here in my mega scans folder, surface, I'm just going to throw this cobblestone material in here. Nothing too crazy. And then I'm going to leave everything else at default down here. And I'm just going to click on create. Now you can see we have a really basic terrain. Let me close my content browser. Maybe I'm going to come to the center here and let's add some different variety in here. I'm just going to raise this up just a tad bit. Nothing too crazy. I just wanted to get a little bit of variety here in the terrain. So we have different height that we could kind of build off of. And there we go. So I'm going to come back down here to my content drawer. I'm going to come right here to where we see main level in my main folder here. I'm going to right click, scroll down, and you should see this right here. It says PCG because we had turned on these plugins earlier. And right here where it says PCG graph, I'm going to left click on this. And then I'm just going to name this one cargo. And now we have this box here that says PC graph. So if I double click on this, this is going to bring up the graph as I showed you earlier. And this is really simple. Like this is basically blueprint, right? Like if I select this down, these are going to be the main ones that you're probably going to use. Like we have some terrain here and some height. So I'm going to use this landscape height. I'm just going to left click on this one, drag it out. And then I'm going to type in surface. And that's going to bring up sampler, surface sampler. So I'm going to left click on this. And now you see we have our node here, but let me move this output out of the way. I'm going to scroll my mouse, move back a little bit, right click just to grab the hand, move this over, because down here inside of my PCG graph, I'm going to right click and I'm going to type in transform. And that's going to bring right here under spatial transform points. So if I left click on this, now you can see we have transform points, which on the right hand side, you can see this is where we're going to change out like our rotation, our location and our scale. So again, it's as easy as coming right here under output, left clicking, bringing it to the endpoint. And now we have this connected. Now, before proceeding, I'm going to show you first how we could do this using a blueprint, because that's something that I haven't seen anybody out there cover yet. Everybody's been doing static meshes, but with blueprints, it's a little bit different. So for this example, I'm just going to start with one. And if I come down here inside of my PCG graph, I'm going to right click and I'm just going to type in actor. And right here under spawner, you should see spawn actor. So I'm going to left click on this. And this is what we're going to be able to bring our blueprints into. So if I select this and bring it into the out here, and now we're connected. So right here under settings where it says template actor class, this is actually where we want to bring the Kitbash. So we can actually drag and drop it. So let me minimize this a little bit. Make sure I still have that selected. I'm going to come down here to my content drawer. Let me make sure this is always showing. So this is where having like two monitors or ultra wide monitor kind of helps out, but I'm going to come down here to my cargo folder right here where it says actors. Then I'm just going to select this first blueprint right here. So I'm going to left click, drag it under here. And now you see we have our blueprint class right there selected. So if I make this full screen, you can see that we actually have the Kitbash model inside of here, the whole blueprint. So I'm going to click on save and then I'm going to minimize this. And you can see that we don't have anything in our scene. That's because we need to drag our PCB here inside of our scene. So down here in my content browser, I'm going to come down here where I have my PCG graph. I'm just going to left click, drag it into my scene. And you can see it already started building it. All right. Yeah, let's fix this right here. Let me drag this over a little bit. I'm going to come down here to where it says location. I'm going to zero this out. And then for my scale, maybe let's make this 50. And you can see everything is happening inside this volume box, but we have a lot going on, and that's why some of it disappeared, because we need to go through and we need to fix this. So I'm going to open back up my PCG graph, and right here where it says surface sampler, let me actually make this a little bit smaller so we can see what's happening inside of our viewport here as well. So with this selected right here where it says looseness, I'm actually going to select 3. And now you can see there's a lot less in here. Let me actually come up, make it a little bit larger. So let's do 5. And now we can see that we're starting to see our whole blueprint in here, because it was really heavy before because we had too much inside of our bounding box. So for right now, let's maybe just go with 8, make it a lot less, but you can see what's happening here. So now we have our blueprint here and it's on top of our surface. And now if I look inside of my viewport, you can see we have all these tints here, but a lot of them are kind of really close to each other. And this is where the transform tool is going to come in and be suffice. So I just wanted to cover that part because I haven't seen anybody show you guys how you could bring blueprints into PCG. It's always been with meshes, but now let's proceed to adding some variety and adding a lot more blueprints into our scene here. So with cargo open right now, I actually want to show you guys something here. So if I come right here to surface sampler, and on my right hand side right here where it says debug, I'm going to left click on this. Now, if I come back here inside of my viewport, you can see we have a lot of points here. And this is basically what's going to be engulfed inside of our volume here for our PCG. So hopefully you guys can see this box here. But everything that's inside of here is actually going to be sticking to our terrain there. And these little dots, this represents everything that we're going to be bringing in with our mesh. So if you have maybe a slower computer or you're going to be using a lot of items, you might want to do it this way first, just to kind of get everything scattered out, see how you want it to be, and then you can start adding your mesh there. With my surface sampler selected, I'm going to hit D, and that's going to take it out. But again, that's going to put it in debug mode. If you need to find that, make sure you have your node selected right here under debug, make sure it's enabled, and hit debug. So moving on from here, I'm actually going to come right here where it says output, and I'm just going to left click and drag this out, and I'm going to type in density, and I want to use the one right here under filter called density filter. So if I left click on this one, and then I'm going to do the same thing here, I'm going to hit debug on this one so we can see what's going on inside of our viewport. You can see our dots change color. They're a little bit lighter, and this is how we're going to separate all of our different items. So a density filter selected right here where it says lower bound, I'm actually going to hit 0. In upper bound, I'm just going to make this one, let's say like 0.3, because we're going to be using 3 different items. And so you can see right now our selection filter has these black dots, and this is going to represent one item that we want to bring in here. Now, if I take this and just hit Control C, Control V, I just copied and pasted it, and I'm just going to bring this output right here from a transform into the endpoint on my density filter. And right here where it says lower bound, I'm just going to bring it up to 0.31. And where it says upper bound, I'm just going to have it at 0.6. And then again, I'm just going to select this, hit D on my keyboard, and that's going to bring this into debug mode also, which you can tell it's in debug mode because it has this little circle in the top left here. But now you can see we have a bigger variety of points in here. So our top density filter is going to be the black ones. This one right here is going to be these gray ones. And then again, I'm going to hit Control V just to paste the density filter in here again. I'm going to connect this. And then right here, where it says lower bound with this selected, I'm going to do 0.61. And I'm going to make my upper bound 1. And then again, I'm just going to enable the debug. So I'm going to do it manually this time right here where it says debug. Left click right here. And now you can see we have some white dots in here. So basically, I'm using a filter to determine what items I want to have on my terrain at any given point. So in this instance, I'm using 3. And so I have 3 filters, but just make sure you can keep track with everything you do. Make sure your nodes are clean. So proceeding on here, I'm just going to right click, move this over, and then I'm going to come to my top density filter, left click, drag this out, and I'm just going to type in actor again. And I'm going to bring in my spawn actor, and you're going to see an error, and that's because it wants a blueprint in here. So let me scroll this over to the top up here, scroll this over a little bit. Right here where it says Templar Actor Class, this is where I'm going to bring my blueprint right here. So under Cargo, Actors, select this one right here, left click, bring it in there. Now you can see we have some tints starting to come in here. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to copy this and paste it. And then I'm just going to come and pick this middle actor right here. I'm going to left click, drag this into here. Then my output on my density filter, bringing it to my input here. Now you can see we have a little bit more tints in here, adding some variety. So you can see where I'm going with this inside of my viewport. So again, Control V. I'm going to do the same thing for this spawn actor. Left click, drag it in here. Let's connect it. Now we have some tints in here and they're all different. So now this is where you could go through, add some variety if you want to. So if I come over here, let's do surface sample first, because right now my looseness is at 6. Maybe let's bring this down to 4. Add a lot more in here. You can see it's getting a little bit more crowded in here. And we're just going to want to break this up a little bit. So right here under my transform points, let me actually make this a little bit larger. I'm going to come over here. I already have absolute rotation on. And you can see I already changed earlier my scale to 1 and 0.8 right here. I have absolute scale selected, uniform scale, recompute seed. I'm actually just going to bring this down to like 500, just add some variety there. And then let's see what's happening here. So inside of my rotation, maybe let's change this one to like 500. Rotate these out a little bit more, maybe 1500. So you can see the variety that is adding in there. Maybe if I come over here, let's come back to my surface sample, maybe change this looseness to 5, just so it's not so crowded. But you can see how you could just come in here, kind of play around with these different nodes. And that's basically it. So that's how you could go through, add PCG to a blueprint actor using cargo to add some variety to your scene. So just to show you guys one last time, if I come over here, let me drag this over just so you can see how my node structure is looking. So I have my import and it's coming to my landscape height, my surface sampler, transform points. I'm using density filters here to filter out all my different blueprints. And if you want to use blueprints, I'm using my spawn actors right here, connecting them to my density filters, and we're all good to go. So hopefully that helped you guys get started out. Using cargo is pretty cool. It reminds me a lot of how Quixel uses mega scans. It's really easy. Select what you want, input it, and you're off to the races. So if you did find this helpful, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're new. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know if you have some tips using PCG. And until next time, stay fresh, keep creating, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Take care.